the inaugural season of indoor lacrosse here on Long Island. Tonight, we're live from the Nassau Coliseum in Uniondale, New York. The New York Titans are facing off against the San Jose Stealth. Well, hi, everyone. I'm Carl Reuter, joined by Sal Acasio. And, Sal, it's no secret. Both of these teams are struggling. Both of these teams desperate need of a victory.
Carl, both teams do need a victory in a desperate way. Both teams come in with just only one win, but you expect that from the expansion Titans. They're a young team. They've shown a lot of promise this year, and it's real important for them tonight to get off to a quick start to try to get an early lead and see if they can jump on top of San Jose.
Perhaps that quick start, the leadership from the captain, number one of the Titans, Casey Powell.
Number one, Casey Powell, you said it. The captain, he's a tremendous player, Carl. He not only can he create for himself, he does a terrific job doing that. He also makes his teammates better. So one thing you have to love about Casey Powell, if you're going to single cover him, he's going to beat his player. If you're going to throw a double team at him, he's going to find the open teammate, and it's no coincidence that he is the leading scorer in lacrosse this year.
And, of course, number one, Casey Powell, will get lots of help tonight from his teammate, number 42. We're talking about Pat Maddalena.
Number 42, Pat Maddalena, has had a tremendous year this year for the Titans to this point. He's a left-hander, so he plays the opposite side of Casey Powell. And what makes Maddalena such a good player, Carl, is he can play without the ball. He's a great finisher. He moves his feet, picks up the loose balls, and finishes. And you need that when you're a right-handed team attacking with the likes of Casey Powell. You need somebody on the left-hand side who can finish, and Pat Maddalena is that guy.
All right, speaking of finishing for San Jose, how do you contain their leading goal scorer, number nine? He's got 19 so far this year. We're talking about Jeff Zywicki.
Carl, you said it. Out of the University of Massachusetts, number nine, Jeff Zywicki is a tremendous offensive player. He has a devastating shot from outside. He's a terrific finisher in tight, and again, like many great players, Carl, he makes his teammates better. Same thing with him. You throw a double team at him, and he's going to find the open player. But the Titans, to win tonight, they have to find a way to slow down number nine, Jeff Zywicki.
Slow down Zywicki and also get the faceoffs. In this game of lacrosse, faceoffs are always an important factor. Lady Liberty, that's right, she's joining us tonight. Sal and I are coming back live from the Nassau Coliseum with the opening faceoff right after this timeout. Stay with us.
Welcome back to Nassau Coliseum as we are moments away from the start of the New York Titans taking on the San Jose Stealth. It's National Lacrosse League action here on SNY. I'm Eamon McEnany, and for those of you who are new to the National Lacrosse League, let's go over the ground rules so you're up to speed when the ball game starts. First of all, both teams will have five players on the field plus the goalie, unless of course there is a penalty, then there will be an extra man situation. The teams have 16 runners and two goalies will dress. There is a 30-second shot clock. The midfield line acts as an over and back line, just like in basketball. There are no offsides, and there will be offensive and defensive specialists. As for the league in general, there are 13 teams, both in the United States and in Canada. They both play a 16-game regular season, starting in January all the way to April, and all games are played on the weekends. The Titans are in the Eastern Division, along with Buffalo, Rochester, the Philadelphia Wings, Toronto, Minnesota, and the Chicago Shamrocks. Now, as Sal and Carl mentioned, top four teams from each division make the playoffs, and once we get to the postseason, it is single-game elimination. Now, as Carl and Sal mentioned, this is a matchup between two desperate teams. Both the Titans and the Stealth only have one win apiece. Coach Adam Mueller told me the key for New York is staying out of the box. When the Titans are at full strength, the offense is dynamic, but they have been taking too many penalties, and that has been the difference between winning and losing. And now, an interesting sidebar to tonight's matchup. Four Titans are former members of San Jose: Matt Ulrich, Ryan Boyle, Matt Vinc, and Jarett Park. I spoke to Ryan Boyle before the game. He said he's never done this before in his lacrosse career, and he said it didn't really hit him until he saw his former teammates out on the field in uniform during warmups. And another interesting point, Matt Ulrich is also playing against a former college teammate. He and Luke Wiles played together at Delaware, and Luke is staying with Matt this week in New York, so Matt definitely wants to pick up a win so he has bragging rights back at the house. Now, as I mentioned, we are moments away from the Titans hosting the Stealth here at the Nassau Coliseum. Let's send it back upstairs to Sal and Carl.
All right, Eamon McEnany, thank you so much, as we're just about set for action here from the Nassau Coliseum. National Lacrosse League action. As you look at Anthony Cosmo, he's from Ontario, 6'2", 210-pounder. He'll wear number 44 between the pipes for San Jose. comes in with a record of 1-5. And on the flip side, Matt Vinc will wear number 48. Collegiately played at Canisius in the Buffalo area at 6'1", 225 pounds. Take a look at the coaches for tonight's game. Walt Christensen talked about the games that he's lost. Five losses this year, record of 1-5. Those five losses by a total of only 12 goals. They have not played since February 3rd, so 3 weeks without action. That last game, a 15-11 loss to Calgary. Adam Mueller. This is his 18th year overall in the National Lacrosse League. Last year he was the head coach at Minnesota, went 8-8. He's a graduate of Michigan State. And during his tenure as a player in this league, he played 75 games, scoring 50 goals, 69 assists, but maybe more importantly, Sal Lacasio, dynamite on loose balls, picked up 259. Now, will his team echo what he did as a player?
I'll tell you, Carl, it's going to be important tonight. In any lacrosse game, Carl, you've got to be able to pick up the loose balls. We'll see them, you know, on face-offs during the course of the game, on shots wide, because, again, there's no out-of-bounds. There's going to be lots of rebounds, lots of balls. Loose balls are always critical in an indoor lacrosse game.
You mentioned face-offs. As a team overall this year, San Jose, 52%. New York at only 44%, thus the records for these two teams. So, we're underway. The New York Titans will be in the home white, and San Jose is in black and red. And, folks, this is a fast-paced game. Don't blink, you'll miss something. First shot of the game was a little bit wide, taken off the boards there. That rebound was by number 19, Mike McClellan. In front, tight shot, and denied was number 24, Gaywas Schwindler of New York.
I'll tell you, Carl, some good offense out there by the Titans, getting some high-quality shots from right in front of the San Jose goal.
And the goalie, Cosmo, will look to clear first possession of this game, four quarters, 15 minutes each. Number 11 is Kyle Sorensen, and he dropped it off. As coming to the near side, number 15, Luke Wiles for San Jose. San Jose averages a little bit more than 11 goals a game, giving up about 13. In tight, Zywicki, the first goal, no crease violation. Take that goal away, Sal, crease violation.
I tell you, that was a great one-on-one move there by Jeff Zywicki, and what the stealth did there is they flooded the opposite side of the floor, let Zywicki go to work, he goes down under and over the top, but you can see that his foot was definitely in the crease. The official made the appropriate call.
So that violation will give it back, and there's a shot off the screen. Brendan Mundorf, but able to answer the challenge, and here's a quick outlet in front of the field, and then going down was number 21. Steve Holmes was taken down from behind. We have our first whistle, our first call of the game.
And Carl, that was started from a real nice save by Anthony Cosmo. Controlled the rebound, made the long outlet pass, and put the Titans in a bind. They were trying to get their offensive players off the field. They were making the long run from the bench. And here you see the stealth player could have an opportunity here if the Titans player doesn't pull him down.
In the box, number 56, John Orson from New York. It was a holding call. Try to go over the shoulder there. Shooting was number 23, Gary Rozicki.
You'll see a lot of that call, especially from the Canadian players. They typically play one side, and Gary Rozicki plays left-handed as opposed to putting the ball in, or the stick in his right hand. He chooses to shoot that ball behind the back.
There's a minute and 35 left on this advantage right now.
Call here the Titans' strategy is just to, you know, take as much time off the clock and see if they can get a shot with only a couple of seconds left.
That's Casey Powell. The bounce shot went wide of the cage, comes off the boards, hauled in there by number 6, Curtis Hodgson, and then he drops it off with 1:10 left on this penalty. In control is Luke Wiles, number 15, plays catch with number 9, Jeff Zywicki. Number 7 is Colin Doyle. He is an excellent player in this league, is Doyle. Doyle looking down low, gets the return pass, rifles the shot, and a tough save there by Matt Vinc.
That was an outstanding stop, but the turnover just cost the Titans, and number 15, Luke Wiles, with the right-handed finish. Tell you, call real nice save there by Matt Vinc. The Titans control the ball. They made a bad outlet pass here. Here we go. Here's a shot by Colin Doyle. Great stop there by Matt Vinc. Then the poor pass here. Picked off by number 15, Luke Wiles, and he finishes top left corner to give the Stealth a one-goal lead.
12th goal of the season for Luke Wiles out of Orillia, Ontario. So the Titans are down early here in this first quarter, but folks, they score them at a rapid rate in this league. Oh, what a beautiful leg save that was. And it's still loose underneath the goalie. I don't think that Cosmo really knew that he had it, Sal.
I'll tell you, Carl, Anthony Cosmo has gotten off to a really nice start here, making four or five early saves, but there's a quality save that he's making. The Titans are getting to the front of the cage. That was another tremendous stop. And as a goalie, when you don't know where the ball is and you don't hear the lights on, you know that that ball is somewhere in your padding, like it was there for Anthony Cosmo.
Number five is Callum Crawford taking it off the boards as Gary Rzyski in tight. Rzyski tries to go over that shoulder. And we've got another call that's been made. It's a crease violation against San Jose. Gives it back to the Titans.
And you'll see quite a bit of that during the course of the game. Both teams want to get real tight to the goal, try to get in front, and they'll be tiptoeing around that crease there trying to finish before they actually step in.
That was Schwindler. Down low it goes, pushed it to the crease. Another good save there by Cosmo. The play goes on. Pushing, shoving, and banging along the far boards, and San Jose comes up with a loose ball.
And that's just a little bit about indoor lacrosse, Carl. They're going to let you bang around in the corners a little bit. Heck, you got to suck it up. You got to put your nose down and get all over those loose balls.
Played a little bit more than 4 minutes of this first quarter. 1-0 San Jose on the 12th goal of the season by number 15, Luke Wiles. Crawford, oh, the runner, and then shooting it wide was Doyle, who got a tremendous feed but couldn't find the cage.
What a feed that was, but here come the Titans.
And out of the cage, but getting back in for San Jose and making that big save there was Anthony Cosmo. It's still loose on the surface. Greg Pizer, number 20, on the field for the first time. Number two is Mundorf. Behind the cage is Casey Powell, a graduate of Syracuse. Titans looking for the tying goal. Mundorf rifles and scores!
I'll tell you, that's a big finish there, Carl. It's amazing how momentum goes. The Stealth had a great opportunity. Colin Doyle shot it just wide. Here come the Titans, and Brendan Mundorf with an outside shot that beats Anthony Cosmo down low. Tremendous goal to tie this one up at one. Here's the look, Mundorf with the catch, a partial screen, and beats Anthony Cosmo down low to tie this one up at one.
Mundorf nets his 11th of the season, the assist to Powell at 5:02, and this game is tied at one with 9:45 left in this first quarter of play, live from the Nassau Coliseum, Uniondale, New York. National Lacrosse League action. Casey Powell twisting and turning, maintains possession. Schwindler, number 24, trying to find an opening, and then fires and hit the pipe.
That was a great shot by Gaywa Schwindler. He's got a tremendous blast from the outside, and that one was definitely ringing the iron.
Hodson comes back near side for San Jose. Wiles, who has the one goal for San Jose, goes across the field on the pass with the step knocked from behind out of his stick. And chasing it down, San Jose on a knee in front. The shot was a save. Shot right on, Sal.
I'll tell you, Paul, both goalies just standing on their head right here. Both are playing terrific. That was a nice stop in there by Matt Vinc on that shot in real tight.
And that shot in tight, Andrew Buckholder, number 37. The fake, the shot, and that one wide. That was Wiles again.
Both teams are getting tremendous chances and getting high percentage shots here, Carl. I expect there to be quite a bit of scoring in the next few minutes.
Matt Aldrich runs off number 7. Here's Mundorf, who scored the tying goal just moments ago for New York. There's the drop off. There's a shot. Just getting a piece was Cosmo. A rifle there by Pat Madalena.
And another quality shot. Right shoulder save there by Anthony Cosmo. And that's another big time stop.
Coming down to 8:10 remaining in this first quarter. In tight. That got the post.
I tell you, what a nice feed by number 9. Jeff Zywicki feeding it inside to give his teammate a high-quality chance. Number 29, Cam Segman.
In front, that one went wide, draped all over. Jarett Park doing some great defense there on Andrew Bruckholder. And now here come the Titans with the clear.
They got some transition if they push it here, Paul.
Jeff Spano gave it up. Oh, behind the back, and it went in!
What a shot. You're not going to see a prettier goal than this. That's number 1, Casey Powell, catching that ball in the right-handed shooting position. And what does he do? He puts it behind the back and finds the back of the net. There's a little magic from number 1 from Syracuse University, Casey Powell. Here's the catch. The goalie thinks he's going to shoot it right-handed, and boom! Puts that one behind the pipe, short side, catching Anthony Cosmo. Not ready for that one. What a magician. What a shot. You're not going to see a prettier goal than that call.
16th of the year for Casey Powell, who wears number 1 for the New York Titans. 7:42 remains in this first quarter. The New York Titans lead it by the score of 2-1 over San Jose. Coming back with more from the Nassau Coliseum right after this timeout. Stay with us.
Tell you, Carl, those are three terrific sponsors to have for a lacrosse game.
Absolutely.
You need lacrosse equipment, Lacrosse Unlimited. You need a hospital to kind of go to after the beat that you take out here. And a little physical therapy and rehab is really what you need to get ready for the game.
Right now, we are pretty much midway through this first quarter. San Jose scored first on a goal by Luke Wiles, but the Titans have answered with Mundorf and then Casey Powell right before the commercial. You will never, as you said, Sal, see a prettier goal over the shoulder, catching the goaltender totally by surprise, Anthony Cosmo.
I tell you, it's amazing what Casey Powell can do. Let's see what he's got for an encore call in the next 3.5 quarters.
7 minutes remain, first quarter. It's tight. Are they going to get a crease violation here, or was he pushed in? Let's wait for the word. Cosmo still on his back, now getting up.
He took a tough one there to the knees with the offensive player there on the Titans, trying to dive to make a finish. It looks like we're going to get both players called for this call. I think we're going to get a push on the stealth, and then also number 1, Casey Powell for goalie interference.
That's what we just heard there, a little goalie interference as Powell goes off. Santos will sit down as well in the box.
That's a good call by the official. There's definitely a push there by number 20, Shane Santos, on the stealth. But you also, you have to protect the goalies in this league. You know, they're a little bit vulnerable out there. So, and Casey, you know, drove to the net, which is what you want to do. You know, and then he had no choice. He got pushed, he dove. And I think it was kind of the appropriate call there to make.
So it's 2 minutes on Casey Powell in the box. The time of these penalties at 8:05.
Make sure it's up there.
They're going to play 4-on-4 right now, and it's 2 minutes for Santos as well. So this will really open up the field here, Sal, 4-on-4.
It really does cause a lot of room, a lot of space out there, so look for some real nice offense on both ends of the floor.
Ryan Boyle, 14, holding behind the cage in the home white for the New York Titans. Shot right on by Madalena, but that was pretty much right into the old wheelhouse there of Anthony Cosmo.
Got to make a fake there without two keepers. Here to go 5-point. Got to get him to lift that stick up. And if Madalena caught that pass, and just one time, they really need to make a little bit of a pump fake to try to get him to move that stick.
Luke Wiles on the field right now. Number 9 is Jeff Zywicki trying to maneuver. It was Zywicki. Oh, what a great save!
I'll tell you, that
by Matt Vinc.
Oh, great move there by Zywicki, and even better save by Matt Vinc.
We talked about Zywicki in the open, how he leads this team with 19 goals. Denied number 20 right there. Oh, trying to lull the goaltender to sleep just a little bit there, Matt Vinc.
I think Matt Vinc may have gotten a piece of this one, or the pipe may have been. Whoa, what a stop there by Matt Vinc. That's a big-time stop. Kick save. Got the stick out on that one. Beautiful stop there on a very good finisher in Jeff Zywicki. Nice stop by Matt Vinc.
Sal, you played in the league for so many years. The reaction time of a goalie is what on the indoor game as opposed to the outdoor? And there's a goal. scoring is Jeff Zywicki. You might stop him once, but you won't stop him a second time.
I tell you, and that's, you know, we talked about this in the opening. You got to try to control Jeff Zywicki. You're not going to stop him completely, but Carl, he's getting himself to some real good shooting positions, and that's going to make it real tough on the Titans defense and real tough on Matt Vinc. Great finish there by number 9, Jeff Zywicki. Tremendous finisher that he is. Outstanding hands, Carl. He's got some of the best hands that you're seeing lacrosse. And here's the catch. Nice little roll dodge. He's going to go back to the middle of the field. Nice shot. Top shelf.
And then going a little bit high as we come back to the live action. Jarett Park missing Zywicki's 20. It ties the game at 9:30 of this first quarter of action. Approaching 5 minutes remaining. There's a nice little bounce pass. Ian Hawksby, number 88, first appearance tonight for San Jose. Luke Wiles momentarily was open, off the spin, gets the pass out. Down low it goes as San Jose works it now. Both players out of the penalty box. Santos and Powell both out for their respective teams. And in it tight, nobody home there. And I'll tell you, Colin Doyle had nothing but an empty net to shoot at, and he was able to beat Matt Vinc.
Okay, Colin Doyle is a big body, and he used his big body to create some space. See him leaning on the defensive player, boom, getting some time and room, and you can't give Colin Doyle that kind of time and room from 10 yards out in front of the goal. Terrific finish, lower left-hand corner by Colin Doyle.
Doyle's seventh. He's more of a feeder because he had 26 assists now to go with that seventh goal of the year. Comes at 10-16. Two straight by San Jose to take a 3-2 lead, 4.5 left first quarter. Staking away was Callum Crawford, number 5, for San Jose.
Another thing you're seeing, Paul, is he's going across a lot of picks, both on the ball and off ball. Picking his lead.
Oh, a nice snag and intercepting that pass. Matt Zash, number 15. Here's John Orson, 56. Comes to the near side to Jeff Spano.
Real nice defense there by the Titans of Matt Zash. He has a very bright future ahead of him. Probably going to be a terrific defensive transition player in this league.
Mundorf got in, but poke check from behind. I believe it was Curtis Hodgson, number 6, who got a stick on it, taking it away. And here's Hodgson at the other end. Off the spin, slows it down. Zywicki, oh, what a great goal! You talk about a catch and shoot! Unbelievable as the Stealth score the fourth goal of this first quarter.
And I'll tell you what, that was set up by number 9, Jeff Zywicki, getting the ball to Cam Sedgwick, and what a one-timer. He actually had himself almost behind the goal, as you can see from this angle. Very difficult for Matt Vinc, who's trying to cut the angle down on Zywicki. Cross-cage feed like that, caught by Cam Sedgwick, almost behind the goal. Great finish by the Stealth.
Fifth of the season for Sedgwick. Three straight goals for San Jose. Leading it right now by the score of 4-2. Coming back to the Coliseum right after this. Catch up on all the latest news and information about your New York Titans by visiting NewYorkTitans.com, NYTitans.com. At NewYorkTitans.com, you can purchase tickets, download the regular season schedule, and much more. It's all just a click away at NYTitans.com. Carl Reuter, Sal Acasio, Eamon McEnany back here at the Nassau Coliseum in Uniondale with San Jose leading at 4-2 based on this goal as well.
I tell you, what a feed there by number 9, Jeff Zywicki. We saw him earlier finish, tremendous finisher inside. Right there, we got a good look at how he makes his teammates better. Terrific fit, terrific pass to Ken Segment for the finishing goal.
That goal came at 11:22 of this first quarter. Three straight goals by San Jose.
So we got right now, Carl, we have a penalty on the San Jose Stealth. So we see the Titans will now go to a 6-on-5 to see if they can get a goal before the penalty is actually called.
Just like in hockey, they have pulled the goalie. They work it behind the cage. That's Casey Powell over the shoulder. And then denied in tight was Mike McLennan. But a great save there by number 44, Anthony Cosmo. A little pushing and shoving and some extracurricular in this league.
That's just all part of the play out there, Carl. But again, I'll tell you, we've seen a treat here from Casey Powell. He saw a tremendous finish there before behind the back. As if that's not enough, now he's making feeds behind the back. And I'll tell you what, he can put it on a dime. What a finish that was. Here's the feed by Casey Powell, but even a better stop there by Anthony Cosmo. Real nice stop there, number 19, Mike McClellan.
So the penalty was a cross check. It's 2 minutes, and now the Titans playing with the extra man. Adelina, up top it goes to Captain Rifles. One never made it to the cage. Was stopped before it got to the goaltender, Anthony Cosmo. And here comes San Jose looking to kill a little bit of clock here.
Recall, plenty of time on the penalty. You still have a minute and a half on the penalty. To be the Titans, you've got the shot clock. There's only 18 seconds left as we speak. You just have to stop them, and it'll give yourself at least a minute left on the power play.
Kyle Sorensen, number 11, in the box for San Jose. 1:20 left on this advantage. Killing it off nicely. There's Crawford just chewing big time seconds. Took a shot, went wide, high off the backboard. And we have another whistle. And I think we're going to have, is this going to be a penalty on the Titans? Yes, it is.
Yeah, number 71, Kevin Galbraith there. That's a tough penalty to take.
Yep.
You're ready in a power play situation. The offensive player in the stealth had already made that shot. And Kevin Galbraith gave a little bit of the business there after he took that shot with a little, you know, little cross check, little mini cross check, little slash there. And tough one to take there when you're on the power play.
In tight, would not go there. Colin Doyle looking for it. So the slash, 2 minutes. Galbraith will sit down. Little unsettled situation, but San Jose manages to get back defensively. Comes out to number 42 is Madalena. Number 2 is Brendan Mundorf. In tight, over the shoulder. Nice save there by Cosmo. Was not fooled that time. Aaron pass, corralled. Eric Martin, 25, San Jose, near side. In tight, shot score! Oh, the finish there by Andrew Burkholder. 5-2 San Jose.
That one was started with a real nice stop there by Anthony Cosmo, and then the transition game of the San Jose Stealth here, beating the Titans down the floor and finishing by number 37 there for the San Jose Stealth, Andrew Burkholder. Here you go with their transition. Nice cross cage feed, and boom, Burkholder finishing down low between the legs of Matt Vinc.
First goal of the season for Burkholder. In tight shot, and he was denied. Coming in there was Zywicki. Sal, how important, if you don't control the rebound offensively, the defense picks it up, the unsettled situation, you go right back from defense to offense, and bingo, you score a goal.
I'll tell you, Paul, the huge part of in-goal lacrosse is the transition component of it. And a lot of teams, including the Titans, are trying to sub players off the field from offense back to defense, and you really, right away, when you see the other team come up with the ball, you've got to hightail it to that bench so that you don't get beat in transition and you get your defensive players on the floor.
Hawksby thought about it, but then number 88 retreats as San Jose had made a line change. It would have been 1-on-3, so Hawksby says possession more important than going in there trying to shoot 1-on-3. There's a shot by Zywicki right on. Vinc came up with it. It's loose, and Vinc, with the big clamp of that goalie stick, gets possession and comes to the near side to number 32, Rich Bresky, for the New York Titans.
Nice stop and nice controlling of the rebound there by Matt Vinc. And again, as you mentioned, Paul, controlling those rebounds and loose balls, absolutely critical in indoor lacrosse.
Swindler, number 24. Pushed out of the way there was Madalena. Composes himself. The bounce pass behind the net to Casey Powell, as good as they get. Look for Madalena, who lost his stick, never got a shot off, and we have a whistle. And that whistle was right around the crease area of the San Jose goalie with 8.2 seconds remaining. And we've got a timeout that's been called on the field with 8.2. San Jose leading it by the score of 5-2. San Jose with one more shot than the Titans at 12-11.
And Carl, look here for the San Jose Stealth. They may pull their goalie, Carl. Risk having an empty net, although it's a low risk with only 8.2 seconds to go, and they may try to attack with 6 offensive players. Right now, the Stealth are setting up their offense, and it looks right now that 1-2, I see 5 players on the floor, so it looks right now that they may be only going with 5.
Well, Sal, join us for our pregame tavern tour, Titans on Tap, before the Titans home game March 3rd at Madison Square Garden. Meet up with or make some new friends. Game ticket, great drink specials for just $15. Go to the website, newyorktitans.com/TitansOnTap to register for more information. That's March 3rd at Madison Square Garden.
Well, here's the 6-on-5 that we just talked about. Stealth decided to pull their goalie. He did get a decent look there. You know, it's not a real high-risk play there with only 8 seconds to go and the full floor for the Titans.
Well, one quarter is over here at the Nassau Coliseum. San Jose leading it by the score of 5-2. Back with the second quarter action
right after this timeout.
Carl Royd along with Sal Acasio, Eamon McEnany working the field downstairs, and you'll hear from him as well during the course of this game. And Sal, it was 2-1 New York. They had scored two straight, but four straight by San Jose to end the quarters. We're going to the second quarter now. Teams will switch sides. What do the Titans have to do to tighten it up just a little bit there?
I tell you, Carl, I think it starts on the offensive end. They've had 14 shots, and they've only scored two goals. And you know what? When you're finishing, Carl, it stops the other team from getting their transition. So I think, you know, even though they've given up five goals on the defensive end, I think a lot of it is actually starting on the offensive end because they're not finishing very well. Anthony Cosmo has made some real nice saves, and I think the San Jose Stealth have done a tremendous job in transition. Now, the transition gets even more promising here in the second and fourth quarters of indoor lacrosse games because you have what we call the short bench, meaning right now the Titans bench is close to the goal they're trying to score. So when they're making their substitutions, it's easier to get transition for both teams in this quarter, but the reverse is true. It's also very challenging for both teams to get back on defense. So look for some more transition in the second quarter.
We have an equipment problem down there with the Anthony Cosmo, the goalie for San Jose. Mentioned San Jose, this is the first game that the Stealth have played since back on February 30, 15-11 loss to Calgary. The only win for San Jose, second game of the season against Calgary by one goal in overtime, 17-16. The only win for New York so far this year, January the 20th, 11-9 over Chicago. The face-off to start this quarter, battle for it right in front of the San Jose bench, about six or seven guys, and the black and red come out with it. Once again, San Jose will now move from left to right on your screen in the black and red. Titans will go from right to left in the home white trimmed in orange. That shot whistled wide, played off the cage. A nice job there by number 29, Cam Sedgwick, to play the carom.
Yeah, it was a nice stop, actually, by Matt Vinc. They got a reset, which means they got 30 more seconds to attack the goal.
Zywicki with a wild pass, and it was taken down by the Titans. Here comes Matt Zesch, streaking right up the middle of the field, and then puts on the brakes and waits for the rest of his teammates as New York makes a little bit of a line change. Near side it comes to Ryan Boyle, number 14. Boyle faked right, then went left, came back to his right, holds it high, looking for an outlet, now moves to his left, tied up there. Great job defensively. There's a bounce shot taken by number 42, Pat Maddalena, that went wide.
And that was off the goalie, Anthony Cosmo. So he was the last one to touch it before that ball went out of play. Titans ball.
And New York puts it right back in, trailing 5-2, first minute and a half of this second quarter. Powell, the drop-off, and the score! Great look by Powell, finds Ryan Boyle, who nets it. The graduate from Princeton brings the New York Titans to within 2 at 5-3.
I tell you, that was tremendous two-man game there by Casey Powell and Ryan Boyle. Here you see the fake pick there, then a little bit of a pick by Ryan Boyle. Casey draws the double team, finds Ryan Boyle with a tremendous finish. Here's Casey drawing the double, flipping the ball to Ryan Boyle. Ryan with an excellent finish. And those two guys, they play tremendous together. And you know what, for you Titans fans, you've got a lot of years of some tremendous play between those two to come. They are just going to get better and better and better.
22nd of the year from Boyle, and those two guys hail from two of the most storied programs in the college game here in the States when you're talking about Syracuse and Princeton.
Carl, they're used to playing in the big show, and they're in the big show now with the Titans here in indoor lacrosse.
Titans want some more. Just cut it to 5-3. Pretty much a weak shot that was sent right on the cage there by Brendan Mundorf. Handled easily by Cosmo between the pipes for San Jose.
You know, Carl, you want to make sure that you're shooting the ball from a high percentage spot. That was not. And he shot it from the wrong side of the field, meaning he was attacking the left side and shot it with his left hand.
San Jose, this is Doyle, number 7, in tight, couldn't corral that pass. Nice look there, but off the stick of Gary Rozicki. And here comes number 7, Matt Aldridge.
They got transition if they push.
Aldridge backs up. Aldridge in front, chased down in the corner, but couldn't gather it in. Was Schwindler, and San Jose coming right back. Number 18 is Darren Halls for San Jose. Halls dropping it off to Sedgwick. He was looking but didn't see the outlet. Now the outlet just steps onto the field for him. Came in the form of number 5, Callum Crawford. Zywicki, you've got to mark that guy tightly. There's a shot right on. Vince is able to save it. Loose, and Vince will come up with it. And he clears. Comes out to Matt Zash over midfield.
Both teams really looking to try to push the transition. Haven't been successful here, but look for both teams to continue to try to do it here in the second quarter.
Zash reversed his field. He is stripped. That's a great job there defensively for San Jose, and give that credit to number 25.
Here's some transition.
Eric Martin in front. 15, taking that shot was Wiles, who opened the scoring in this game. And here's Greg Kaiser. Kaiser with a shot right on, and it was saved by Cosmo. And we've got a player that, is he okay? Yeah, he's okay. That's Greg Kaiser right there.
You know, he had a nice shot there, Carl. Nice stop by Anthony Cosmo there. And then the loose ball got caught under Greg Kaiser, and they called him for a legal procedure there.
You know, back in 2004, Kaiser tied a national record by winning 15 of 15 faceoffs in a game against Hofstra. That's how good Greg Kaiser is.
Terrific player with another young player on the Titans who's got a very bright future ahead.
Shot went wide, and it rolls all the way out to midfield. Now is a break coming up here. Here's Jeff Spano, and Spano went wide on Cosmo.
Went for the short side, excellent transition. Way to run the floor by number 47, Jeff Spano, but he just missed that one, short side, top shelf.
Rebound came out to Galbraith, who gives it to Casey Powell, and you just have to watch Powell. You never know what he's going to do. Not able to bring it in was Brian Tower, number 10, so that pass that Tower can't get comes right back to San Jose.
I tell you, Carl, we're really seeing some end-to-end action here.
Unbelievable.
I tell you what, if this game stays tight, I think it's going to, conditioning is going to play a huge part in this game.
With the step there was Doyle. Still holding on to it. Got a screen, but forced behind the cage. Tried to jump and dump it behind the goaltender and Matt Vinc, but it didn't work. We've talked a lot about Ryan Boyle. Here it is. Bang! It's a two-goal game. We're coming back right after this. Be sure to join us on SNY for two more telecasts from the Nassau Coliseum. March 24th, the Titans take on the Rochester Nighthawks. Then on Saturday, March 31st, a 12:30 p.m. start. The Edmonton Rush visit the Titans. Enjoy Titan lacrosse right here on SNY.
Call you. The Titans are going to be a man down here, and here's why. Here comes the butcher or the slash by number 20, Greg Pizer.
So Pizer in the box for 2 minutes, and San Jose will look to extend its lead. Right now leading it by the score of 5-3, that's Doyle. See if they're deliberate, or if they go when they see the opening, they just try to take that shot, Sal.
You know, and it's what they're doing is they're trying to draw guys with Colin Doyle to the left side of the field, and then to get Zywicki or Wiles with shots from the right-hand side. It was good defense there, though, by the Titans.
Sedgwick denied in tight there by Matt Vinc, and now can New York kill some time on this penalty that shows 90 seconds left on Greg Kaiser, 2 minutes for slashing.
They're going to try to do call. We're down to 8 seconds. They're going to try to take the shot with 2 or 3 seconds and then hopefully pick up the rebound.
And got it off, but Cosmo gets control in the crease, and he comes to the near side, and this is Sedgwick. Coming down to 1 minute left in the penalty on Greg Kaiser. 20 on that shot clock.
Let's make a little noise for the defense.
But in this league, that shot clock really comes into play. That shot right on was stopped by Vince. There's a rebound. Nice move. Oh, Zywicki got the post.
I'll tell you what hand Jeff Zywicki has. Real nice stop there by Matt Vinc on Colin Doyle. Then Jeff Zywicki follows it up, and he rings the bell on the pipe.
45 seconds remain in the advantage. The double team out high, firing it and scoring for San Jose, Gary Roziski.
And Carl, that one there hit the pipe, then hit Matt Vinc in the back, and then ended up in the back of the net. That was a little bit of bad luck there for the Titans. You'll see this here. It looks like Colin Doyle getting it to Gary Roziski, rips it off the pipe, off of Vince, and into the cage. We may get a better look here. Here's the shot. Boom. Off of the pipe, off of Vince, and then back into the back of the net. That's a high-quality shot there by Gary Roziski on the San Jose Stealth.
Lucky number 13 for Roziski on the season. San Jose had 4 shots on that power play advantage. Now have doubled up the Titans, leading at 6-3 in control once again. Inside 8 minutes left. That shot, the save was made by Vince. It's loose in that crease area. Who wants it more? Loose ball is scooped up by Greg Kaiser. Of course, out of that box right now after committing that slashing penalty. There's a nice look. Had the cutter coming down there with Brendan Mundorf along the far side. Drop off.
Boyle and Powell playing a little two-man game there, Carl. You notice the picking for each other.
6 seconds to shoot. Swindler behind the cage with 3 to shoot. Try to drop it in and bank it off the back of Anthony Cosmo. He got it off, but it wasn't the best of shot opportunities.
I tell you, they didn't realize where that rebound actually ended up at his feet, but he was trying to get off the field there so that they didn't get hurt in transition.
Sal, because all these players offensively are so skilled, as a goalie, you play this, you've got to watch behind the cage because you get a guy that will try to bank it off your back.
You never know where the ball's going to come from in Major League, National League Lacrosse here, Carl. But I'll tell you what, one thing I can tell you is they're shooting it as fast as Nolan Ryan can pitch it.
Well, you know what he did. He pretty much broke the radar gun there, going over 100 miles an hour. 6:40 left in this first half of play. San Jose has doubled up the New York Titans 6-3. Each team really needs a win. Each team only with 1 on the season. Spinning, shooting, falling down. Would not be able to answer was Jarett Park, but a great effort by Park.
That's great transition there by the Titans. Got a high-quality shot. Once again, Anthony Cosmo there with 18 saves already in this game to this point.
6 minutes, 8 seconds left. Somebody's lost a glove there. See, that was the save there in front as Park went down. Just kind of lost his footing.
You know, after running the length of the floor, it was a little winded, a little tired, but he did get a high-quality shot. Good offense, good transition there by the Titans.
Cutting back through. We got a crease violation once again by New York with 5:45. Turn it back over to San Jose. We've got another whistle to bring it back.
Here's number 42, Pat Madalena, making a nice loose ball, getting in tight, but again, you saw his toes there, touched the crease before he launched himself to the front of the net.
So, the Stealth put it back in, leading it 6-3 with 5:40 left in this first half of play from the Nassau Coliseum. Paul Reuter along with Sal LaCassio, Eamon McEnany. Behind the cage, looking to duck one in there and through, but Vince holding his ground, but again, a crease violation.
Nice stop there by Matt Vince, but I'll tell you, Carl, this is a critical 5 minutes here for the New York Titans. They're down 3. They don't want this one to get away from them. They need to make sure they get into the locker room at the worst-case scenario down 3, but they'd really like to close the gap here in the second quarter.
There's a goal. And they close the gap to within two at 6-4.
And there's the captain, number one, Casey Powell, once again with a big goal. Starting out of the left-hand side of the floor, getting a little pick there from Ryan Boyle. And I'll tell you, great shot from outside, but what he does there is he uses the defensive player as a screen, so the goalie never gets a good look at that. And Casey Powell finishing that with a bounce shot to the lower left-hand corner. Big goal there by the Titans, and here they come again.
Second of the game, 16th of the season, a save by Cosmo, as now some energy for the New York Titans, Sal, with less than five remaining, has cut it back to two.
I'll tell you, they needed that goal. Excellent time there for their leader, their captain, to step up and make another big play to close this one within two.
Can San Jose answer? Rosiski cut to his right, back to his left, shot, and a save by Matt Vinc. Now, can they cash it in here?
Nice stop, more, and just as important, great job controlling the rebound there by Matt Vinc.
John Orson gave it over to Ryan Boyle in the attacking zone. We go for the New York Titans. There's Ryan Boyle, 12 on that shot clock. Boyle looking for an opening, trying to back his way in tight to the crease. He's triple teamed, still has it. And we've got a whistle and a crease violation. We'll give it back to San Jose. 4:07 remains in this first half of action. The Titans have closed the gap, trailed by two. We're back with more right after this.
I'm Ryan Boyle from the New York Titans. Get your New York sports here.
Fans, for all your lacrosse equipment and apparel needs, visit Lacrosse Unlimited, official retailer of the New York Titans. Visit us at one of our 11 tri-state area locations or online at www.lacrosseunlimited.com. That's Lacrosse Unlimited, official retailer of your New York Titans.
What a nice stop there again by Anthony Cosmo. The Titans right now are on the power play for a two-minute slash by number three, Tim Booth, on the stuff.
This is real big to try to score here. That shot denied was Mike McClellan, because you've cut it to two. You've got the advantage here with only 3:40 left in the half, Sal.
Yep, this is a huge opportunity here for the Titans. Now they have to be smart. Still plenty of time on the penalty. They need to play good, solid D here for the next 15 seconds.
1:22 remaining on the penalty to Tim Booth, sitting it out for a slash. Booth, a graduate of Hobart. And we've got a whistle here.
It's over and back. They made an errant pass there. And you push the ball across the middle of the field. You can't go in the defensive end to get it if you've already established possession in the offensive end.
And in this game, put back into play immediately. Offensive advantage, try to catch the defense flat-footed, in tight, and they score the goal! Score the goal for Mike McClellan. It's a one-goal game on that power play.
Gotta really like the design of this play. They started out from attacking behind the goal. They got the ball to Ryan Boyle, who's got eyes everywhere, and he finds his teammate, Mike McClellan, right in the crease, and what hands inside, what a finish. Here's Ryan Boyle, soft pass inside, McClellan with a nice hand, finishing top shelf.
16th of the season. New York now 1 of 3 on the power play. It's a one-goal game inside 3 minutes remaining in this first half. And now Martin of San Jose pushing. Vassell of San Jose pushing. Greg Pizer, who comes back for some more. And then Pizer bumps into Martin. That's funny, because all these guys have played against each other in college and here in the pros 100,000 times, and they still don't like one another.
I think they're just saying hello to each other and trying to find out what you're doing after the game.
Well, San Jose is going to get on a plane and go back home. 2:45 left. Try to catch him, and there's a nice little steal defensively. Ryan Barrett, number 41 for New York. The drop ball. Oh, and a kick save by Cosmo. Boy, he beat Madalena.
I'll tell you, real nice play, though, by Ryan Barrett, the defensive end of the field. Ran the floor, created transition, got the ball to Madalena. Anthony Cosmo was there, though, to say no.
And we've got a whistle and a stoppage with 2:29 left in this first half from the Nassau Coliseum. We are live from the Nassau Coliseum.
Here's a nice pass there to Pat Madalena. Madalena off the short side. Nice kick save there by Anthony Cosmo.
You know, Sal, when you break it down, the Titans are not that far away. They come in at 1-7, but do you know in four of their seven losses, three goals or less, as we take a look at in the box, number 10, Brian Tower for 2 minutes.
Tower's in there serving a team penalty there for delay of the game. But I'll tell you what, Carl, they're a young team, the Titans. They have a bright future ahead of them. They've got a tremendous coach in Adam Mueller who understands the game really well. And it's going to take a little bit of time, but he's going to build a real good team here in New York with the Titans.
San Jose is 2 of 3 on power play opportunities so far. Looking to cash in once again as we hit the 2-minute mark of this first half. In tight. Oh, and a save there by Matt Vinc off the stick of Jeff Zywicki.
A big save with the right paw there by Matt Vinc off of one of the sharpshooters in Jeff Zywicki.
Nearly a beautiful steal there by Barrett, but he fell down to the surface. 1:15 left on the penalty. 1:41 now left in this first half of play. Doorstep it went. Back out top. Winding, firing, and scoring is number 23, Gary Rosicki. That's another power play goal for San Jose, who now extends to a 7-5 advantage.
That was Gary Rosicki, and that was a stealth bomber there by the San Jose player, call. I tell you, nice look there by Colin Doyle. Using the Titans' defensive player as a screen, Gary Rosicki drops his stick and rifles this one top shelf in the corner. That's a tremendous shot there by Gary Rosicki.
Second goal of the game for Rosicki, 14th of the season. And we're inside 90 seconds in this first half. A two-goal game in favor of the Stealth from San Jose. 37, Andrew Burkholder. Nice little underhand feed. Could not catch in there. Was Colin Doyle. It's loose, and it's Matt Zash behind the cage for the Titans. The long clear. This is Jeff Spano, one-on-one. Spano now backs it out. There's the cutter, there's the feed on the doorstep, and they can't cash in. So much great passing, but they never really got a shot off, Sal.
I'll tell you, that was some great ball movement there. Maybe one too many passes, but you gotta love the unselfish nature there of the Titans players. But here come the Stealth. They've got some transition if they push it.
Transition, and now a timeout has been called with 31.9 seconds remaining in this first half of play. San Jose up by the score of 7-5.
Carl, it'll be interesting to see what the Stealth do here. There's almost 32 seconds left here in the half, but there's only 25 on the shot clock. So we saw at the end of the first quarter where they chose to take the goalie out of the goal to go 6-on-5. I don't think they'll risk it here with a two-goal lead and with the differential of the shot clock and the game clock of 7 seconds.
31.9 on your game clock, 25 on your shot clock. Differential right there, as Sal was talking about, 6.9. Is that St. John's education, math-wise? You like that, Sal?
Well, Carl, I didn't see this. I think we may have a change of possession here. Maybe maybe Titans ball here.
Well, while we have the opportunity, Sports Physical Therapy of New York is the official sports medicine provider for the New York Titans. At Sports PT, we've built our reputation as the leader in physical therapy and sports medicine services by returning athletes to the game. We know what it takes to get you back in action. Sports PT, 28 locations strong, providing compassionate care, compelling results. For more information or to find a facility near you, visit us at www.sptny.com. A little Cotton Eye Joe with 31.9 left. You're not dancing, Sal. You're not dancing.
Carl, this is too much of an exciting game here for me to be dancing in the booth here, but it's going to be interesting to see what the strategy is here for the Titans. They're down two. I don't think they'll pull the goalie here. They probably will just play their typical normal offense. Look for number one, Casey Powell, the leader, and number 14, Ryan Boyle, to get into a two-man game. You'll see some picks. You might see some fake picks. But look for number 1 and 14 to handle the ball, either to try to create for themselves or to create for one of their teammates.
So, once again, well, now they've reset that shot clock to 30. So, basically, New York has it for the rest of this period with the exception of 1.9. Casey Powell whipping around. Titans in control, down by 2:75, 20 seconds left in the half. There's a shot, and the save was made by Cosmo off the stick of Mundorf. And now San Jose looks like they'll just pretty much try to run it out here. That's Ian Hawksby, number 88, with 5 seconds to play. Dumps it into the New York zone. Matt Vinc will take it. And that is the first half of play here from the Nassau Coliseum. And San Jose and New York go to the locker rooms in a two-goal game. The Stealth leading it by the score of 7-5. Fans, get your tickets for the New York Titans lacrosse as the Titans return to Madison Square Garden on March 3rd to take on the Toronto Rock at 8 p.m. Individual game tickets for all Titans regular season home games at the Garden and Nassau Coliseum are available and on sale now at Ticketmaster or Action. Speaking of action, Carl Reuter, Sal Acasio, Eamon McEnany back here live at the Nassau Coliseum. Third quarter, about to unfold. Sal, early on here, San Jose with a two-goal lead. What do the Titans need to do to catch up and then perhaps take the lead?
I'll tell you, they've had some good transition. They've got to do a better job finishing, Carl, but they've got a golden opportunity here with the power play that can help jumpstart them here in the second half.
So Matt Zash will bring it out, and it comes to the near side to Jarett Park, who wears number 12. Flips it over there to Pat Maddalena. Maddalena, number 42, near side. Maddalena down low. Out it goes to Mundorf, who's got a goal in that first half. Casey Powell had a touch, wearing number one, the captain of this team. And a look to try to go right on top of the crease there in Anthony Cosmo. The pass was knocked down short, picked up by San Jose.
That was good defense there by the Stealth there, deflecting that pass, putting the ball on the floor, and then picking up the loose ball here. But the Titans still have an opportunity with almost, looks like about 25 second difference between the shot clock and the penalty. So good defense here, and then they'll still have about 20 seconds to try to get a power play goal.
Joe Vassold is still sitting it in the box with 27 seconds remaining. It's off the backboard, bounces around, and here come the New York Titans with 20 seconds left on that penalty to Vassold. 15 on the penalty. Casey Powell out high. Behind his back it goes to Mike McClellan. He's got a goal in this game as well. Schwindler right on, and Cosmo did not buckle at all.
I'll tell you, he played the angle, came out, challenged the shooter. Real nice stop there by Anthony Cosmo on number 24 for the Titans, Gay Washington.
So San Jose killed it up. There's Zywicki in tight. He goes crashing into the goal, and Matt Vinc goes down as well. And the call is going to be, I thought he was in there for a crease violation.
I'm looking here for a little goalie interference here, Paul.
Are you really?
So Zywicki got that one in kind of tight. It looks like Rory Condon here is walking Jeff Zywicki to the sin bin over here to take a couple of minutes sit down. You know, you've got to control your body. Zywicki's doing what he can there to get to the front of the cage. But you can't be reckless. And in that situation, you know, Rory Condon, the official, felt like he was jeopardizing the goalie and did not try to evade him. So for that, they give him 2 minutes in the sin bin.
And the goalie interference, so Zywicki sits it out for 2 minutes. Can New York capitalize on the opportunity being a man up?
It's the difference in the game to this point. This is their fourth power play. The Titans are 0-3 to this point, while the San Jose Stealth are 3-4. It's definitely been the difference in this game to this point.
Cosmo had knocked that shot down by Mundorf. And now San Jose will look to kill time. 90 seconds remain on the goalie interference call against Jeff Zywicki and San Jose, leading it by 2 goals. Early here in this third quarter of action, live from the Nassau Coliseum on SNY. Left behind the cage, picked up there now by number 7, Matt Ulrich. And here come the New York Titans.
Got a minute left of this power play call. Another golden opportunity here for the Titans to cut this one within one.
Schwindler and Maddalena play catch. Behind the back, Powell went on the pass. Went through the crease, eludes the stick of Maddalena into the big goalie stick. of number 44, Anthony Cosmo. And once again, San Jose, led by Curtis Hodgson, will look to kill time. 15 is Luke Wiles opened this scoring in this game for San Jose in that first quarter. Wow, that was a save made by Matt Vinc with his bare hand.
That was a deflection of a pass that he decided to pick with that one. Cherry picked that one out of the air with the bare hand.
Perhaps one last opportunity here with 15 seconds on this advantage. The man up right now for the Titans, down to 10 seconds. Behind the back it goes, up high now. Shot and a save right on. Denied was Ryan Boyle.
Great save by Anthony Cosmo, and he controlled the rebound. But I'll tell you what, the Titans are really struggling tonight from the left side of the floor. They haven't had much of a contribution to this point from Pat Maddalena or Gaywa Schindler. And if they're going to win this game, they're going to need those two players to step it up offensively.
Titans now 0-4 on the power play situation. Zywicki's out of the box. He has control of the ball. Cut to his left. Watch his hands. It's knocked from behind. Good job there by number 12, Jarett Park. And here comes Spano. Jeff Spano with a streaking Casey Powell, who is stopped cold in his tracks. The rebound in front again. Cosmo comes up big.
Real nice stop there. Real nice stop.
And, oh, a sucker punch. Kyle Sorensen, number 11 for San Jose, going at it. And I'm trying to see that jersey's pulled over that Titan player.
That's Ryan Boyle. That's a cheap shot by number 11.
That's
Kyle Sorensen
through a legitimate cheap shot. And these two guys are really battling. He's got to get more minutes than Boyle for that cheap shot to the face of Ryan Boyle by Kyle Sorensen.
That's as cheap as it gets there, Carl. That's, you know, it went after a guy who's, you know, Ryan Boyle's a tough player, but he's not a fighter. And what a cheap shot there by number 11, Kyle Sorensen.
Look at this.
Here it
is.
Ryan Boyle's not punching him.
He seems to be okay, so obviously Sorensen does not throw much for that haymaker, who is rather weak. Because Boyle showing no ill effects after going into the box. Now, how are they going to sort this out?
I'll tell you, Carl. I just, you know, there's, if you're going to be a tough guy, you pick on somebody on the other team, tough guy. You know, and that's a cowardly move by number 11 there for the San Jose Stealth, and that is Kyle Sorensen. You know, go after some one of the bigger guys, one of the fighters, one of the tougher guys, you know, on the Titans. But he chose to, you know, do a little bit of a cowardly thing there and go after Ryan Boyle, who is not really much of a fighter. I mean, Ryan,
5'11",
soaking wet, he's 180 pounds.
And Sorensen, Sal, is 6'2", 220. Now, just holding him off. Helmet's come off. He's holding him with the left arm, and then, geez. Well, you know, they had a hockey game here earlier today. The New York Islanders playing a matinee and beating the Montreal Canadiens. So now let's see what they put in the box here. Well, two Titans are in the box. Casey Powell is in there now, jawing with Sorensen.
Number one, unsportsmanlike conduct, 2 minutes. Misconduct, 10 minutes.
Sir, we have a 5-on-4.
The sub will serve it. He only ends up serving 10.
So they gave.
Open the door!
I'll tell you, you know, I can't help it. I know it's tough to officiate this game, but I'll tell you, Roy Condon, that's the wrong call out there. How you got now Casey Powell, Ryan Boyle in the box when Kyle Sorensen started this whole thing, and you're giving the San Jose Stealth a power play here?
He may not come over and complain. Black and white.
No, I have to disagree. It's not black and white. This is a very gray matter right now. He made it a gray matter. What is he? Well, it's a San Jose power play. And leading it 7-5 with 10:20 left in this third quarter. Well, that brought everyone to their seats.
It's a big play here. Nice stop there by Matt Vinc. This is a huge part of the game here. The Titans have got to figure out a way here to slow down the San Jose stealth power play. They've been 3-for-4. They need to be able to stop them here. This is a big play in the game. And they've got their two best offensive players, Casey Powell, out for the next 12 minutes. And there's a big goal.
Goal by Greg Pizer, and it's a one-goal game. The Titans close to within 7-6 on the tally by Pizer.
I'll tell you, great finish there by Greg Pizer. Getting the shorthanded goal, that's a big one. It's a nice play here. Getting the ball by Brendan Mundorf, making a nice feed. Pizer catching, finishing down low. Real nice finish by number 20, Greg Pizer, getting the Titans to within one.
So Pizer playing in his first game, scores his first goal, and it's a one-goal game. And if anything, that fight and the penalties probably ignited the Titans. It's a 2-on-1 break. And this game is tied at 7 on the strong, strong finish by number 47, Jeff Spano.
I'll tell you, they're off of the faceoff. It's a loose ball. It's transition. And there's Spano finishing at the offensive end here, catching the ball, finishing on the top shelf. Got a little bit of help there. Looked like his toes were right on the goal line. But heck, you know what? In this game, it's a matter of inches here. Nice finish there by Spano over the top, tying this one up at 7.
Fourth goal of the season for Spano has tied the game at 7. Oh, a different Titan team since the fight and the penalties against them.
I tell you, sometimes you get one of your players that stands up for themselves, like Ryan Boyle there, mixing things up, and it looks like it's kind of giving the Titans some momentum here.
San Jose in control, 2 straight here in this third quarter of action. By New York has tied the game. Oh, what a big save on the doorstep, Matt Vinc. There's a whistle and a timeout on the field. The Nassau Coliseum has become electric. 8:58 to go. Sorensen with the sucker punch. It ignited the New York Titans. And there's a tying goal by Spano. Right, be sure to join us on SNY for two more telecasts from the Nassau Coliseum, March 24th, the Titans taking on Rochester. Then on Saturday, March 31st, afternoon game, 12:30, the Edmonton Rush visit the Titans. Enjoy Titans lacrosse on SNY. So if you can't come out here to watch it, then you can listen and watch Sal and myself as we bring you the action here on SNY.
And I'll tell you, Carl, this indoor lacrosse is just exciting. It's fast-paced. We've seen some terrific plays tonight. We've also seen the physical element, all teams getting after it. And I tell you, you've got to get out here. You've got to see a game. The Titans are a team that is getting better, and they will have a bright future ahead of them.
Play back in. We're inside 4 minutes left in this third quarter. There's a bounce shot, and boy, Matt Vinc made the first save but couldn't stop the rebound shot that came at him and went through, and it's now 9-7 San Jose.
And I'll tell you, the loose ball there absolutely killed the Titans. That was a real nice initial save by Matt Vinc. Then you got the rebound here. Here we go from outside. Here's a shot. Nice stop by Vinc. Here's the loose ball. Titans player misses it, and boom. Nice hands there by number. Looks like number 18 there for the stealth. Darren Halls, real nice finish there with the left-handed finish.
Second of the game, eighth of the season for Doyle, and that gives San Jose a two-goal advantage once again at 9-7 after the Titans had tied the game at 7. Behind the back, nice look. Oh, there's a save by Matt Vinc. He plays it on the back of that cage. And kind of steps on the stick as well, just showing San Jose players, don't come in my territory, and I won't bother you. That was Andrew Burkholder.
Yeah, that circle around the goal is the goalie's home, and you protect your house.
Absolutely. And I'm sure in your days in this league, you did a little house cleaning of yourself.
Every now and then, you got to send a little bit of a message, Carl.
Just a little bit of a message, Sal? Coming down in 3 minutes left in this third quarter of play, live from the Nassau Coliseum in Uniondale, New York. National Lacrosse League action. Turnover, whistle, right back to the New York Titans. I think the Titans could really use a tally here. They don't want to go down 3, Sal. They'd like to cut it to 1 and give themselves some working room here.
It's important, Carl, but they also need their leader, their captain, who's in the penalty box for a couple more minutes. They could really use him on the floor right now.
And basically, Casey Powell has been in there for quite a while now. And it was all started by a sucker punch of San Jose's Kyle Sorensen mixing it up with Ryan Boyle of New York.
I just think the 10-minute misconduct is a tough penalty to be handed out.
It's a ridiculous penalty to have been handed out. Absolutely ridiculous. First of all, he's as good as they come in the league. Cut him some slack there. He's the captain of this team as well. And why do you wear a C? Because you're supposed to be able to go to the officials and talk to them in just a bit, right?
I think you should, as an official, use a little bit more restraint there. But that being said, the Titans are only down 2.
And it's picked up by Tim Booth. Timmy Booth will turn 26 years old tomorrow. That's his birthday. He'd like a long flight back to San Jose with a W. 1:45 left in this third quarter. Titans again. Offensive movement here. Looking to cash in. Tied the game at 7. San Jose answered with 2 straight, leading at 9-7. Adelina. Ducked in and denied. That left leg there of Anthony Cosmo. Whistle. And is this against San Jose? Yes, it is. I can give him a little elbow there, and that's what he's coming off for. So an advantage here now on a power play with 1:24. Sitting it down will be number 88, Ian Hawksby. 2 minutes for the elbow. Sal, this is crucial right now on a power play.
It is another huge opportunity here on the power play. They've really struggled on the power play here tonight, and they've really struggled from the left-hand side. They've had some real good opportunities, just have not been able to finish. They really need Madalena, Mundorf, or Gaywa to finish here.
Playing the carom. There's Mundorf. So far, New York has been denied, as you saw that graphic. They have not been able to score on the power play. And then an errant pass goes into the San Jose bench area, gives the ball to the Stealth with 1:02 remaining. Third quarter.
Definitely been the difference of the game have been the specialty units here, and San Jose has three power play goals, whereas the Titans don't have any to this point.
Wiles, there's a steal. Now can you cash in? It's one on one. Now it's two on one. John Orson faked the shot. They had an opportunity, but they brought it back out with 35 seconds left. A couple of big defensive guys there. Warren looking to shoot with Barrett and then Orson. And then the turnover. And then getting knocked down was Hodson. Loses his helmet. But Martin maintains with 18 seconds. 54 left in the power play for the Titans. Ian Hawksby in the box for San Jose. 10 seconds left. Third quarter coming to an end. Holding on, there's Zywicki. Don't think that he wouldn't take a shot. There it is, as the horn sounds. So, three quarters are in the books. Right now, San Jose with a two-goal lead at 9-7. When we come back in the fourth quarter, New York is still on a power play.
After three quarters of play, the Titans trail by two, or we are set for the fourth quarter. But before we get to that, I am joined by number 29, former NLL star and coach Pat McCabe. And Pat, how do the Titans regain that momentum they had after the fight?
Well, they got good energy there from the fight from Ryan Boyle. I think if you're going to turn it around, first thing you got to try to do is score on a power play. You take those opportunities to get the team down. If you can bury one on a power play, it sends a good message that you can't push our people around anymore.
Now, as we've been saying throughout this game, both of these teams are desperate for a win. Describe for us the intensity on both benches as they get ready to play the fourth quarter.
You look at these last 15 minutes and you say, we have to find a way to get it done. We've only got it done once. Chance to double up your win total right now is huge, and you got to go figure out a way.
All right, Pat, thanks a lot. Let's send it back upstairs to Sal and Carl for the fourth quarter.
All right, Eamon, thanks very much. No matter what the game is, indoor or outdoor, you were looking and talking to one of the best defensemen that ever played the game, Pat McCabe, number 29.
And you know, Carl, he said you have to find a way to get it done. Well, let me tell you something. There was an awful lot of times in that guy's career that he found a way to get it done.
Won a few championships in Syracuse, didn't he?
He's done okay for himself.
Yeah, he's done okay for himself. That's right. Pat McCabe, local product out of Elmont High School right here on Long Island as well. Well, play back in here to start this fourth quarter, and with only 3 seconds left on this power play, I don't know if they'll get that shot off. They won't, but they still have the offensive look, and a score! Oh, what a great feed by Park, who finds a streaking Pat Maddalena. It's a one-goal game.
And there's some of the help they need from the left side of the floor. Great transition by number 12, Jarett Park, running the floor. He actually drew a foul, which they're not calling because the goal disqualifies that. But what a finish here by Maddalena. Here's Park, the backhand feed to Maddalena, finishing far side. And the Titans close this one to within one. Oh, baby, what a finish coming off the bench. Top right-hand corner.
San Jose right back, and it's Hawksby who answers. Oh, just a few seconds later, Ian Hawksby, number 88. Giving San Jose, once again, a two-goal advantage.
I'll tell you, off of the face-off, it's the loose balls, transition created there by San Jose. Excellent ball movement. Here comes the ball down with number 9, the Magic Man, Zywicki, getting that ball across to number 88, Ian Hawksby, with an excellent finish.
But a recap. Maddalena at 42 seconds, cut it to one, and then all of a sudden Hawksby, only 7 seconds later, gives San Jose a two-goal advantage. Second goal of the season for Hawksby out of Niagara-on-the-Lake, Ontario. Great hometown. Oh, the scramble down on the turf. Looking for the shot. Oh, look at that big guy, Matt Vinc, coming up with it.
There's Jeff Zywicki again. He's just a magician with the ball. Terrific shooter, but that time Matt Vinc had the answer.
San Jose on the attack. Luke Wiles, number 15, cutting back. Gives up the ball. We got a whistle.
And that's an illegal pick there on San Jose. That's excellent defense there by the Titans. And they'll get a look here in the offensive end of the field.
And that pick, I believe, is number 37, Andrew Burkholder, who got called for that. Played nearly 2 minutes of this fourth quarter. San Jose leading by two, looking to finish, couldn't hold on, was Madalena. Stick work there, defensively, 18 Darren Halls, and then cutting through the crease with Madalena. Went wide, and then lassoed, and no call was made there. Sorensen is back on the field right now, number 11 for San Jose. He started the melee before with Ryan Boyle that ignited this New York Titans team. And at that time, they had tied it up at 7 after being down by 2.
Just can't seem to get over the hump here, Colin. This next goal is going to be a big one here. With 12 minutes to go, they can't get down by 3. They need to close this one within 1.
Adelena seems to have been shaken up on that bench area for the New York Titans. As New York puts it back in, offensively down by 2. Played nearly 3 minutes of this fourth quarter. Paul Reuter along with Sal Acasio. Eamon McEnany working it downstairs for us. That shot never, ever got there. Knocked down by the defense. It's a 2-on-1 break. Sedgwick scores, and San Jose leads it now by 3.
I'll tell you, that's a terrific finish there by the San Jose Stealth, but it's all started with real good defense, cross-check defense, and then Cam Sedgwick goes the length of the floor, finishes lower left-hand corner. Here's the loose ball, picked up. Here come the Stealth, finishing from that's the money spot in National League Lacrosse. That's where you got to get to, the middle of the floor. Great finish.
Casey Powell back in. Can the captain lead the team back? Down by 3. Number 1 in the home white, Casey Powell. Time of that goal was at 5:05. Cedric, his second of the game for San Jose. Behind the cage, Callum Crawford, Luke Wiles. You know, and in this game, Tucson, you really can't milk all that much clock time, so you're always in the game.
You are always in the game here with that 30-second shot clock, and you're gonna get yourself a bunch more chances. You've just got to play solid D here if you're the Titans and say, you know what, we're going to buckle down here at 11. We're not giving up anymore and start chipping away at this 3-goal lead.
Crease violation against San Jose. It was Jeff Zywicki going into no man's zone. Casey Powell. There's a shot went wide. The carom is played by Ryan Boyle. Boyle getting a screen from Powell and then threw it right on the cage, but Cosmo come up with it. Now it's loose in front. There's a loose ball scoop by Curtis Hodgson, number 6. And here's Sedgwick, who just moments ago scored a goal for San Jose. 4.5 minutes gone by in this fourth quarter. In tight, Zywicki the hands. Oh, Jeff Zywicki. I don't think, Sal Acasio, there are quicker hands in this league than number 9 for San Jose.
I'll tell you what, that was some catch first off in traffic, and then have the hands to make a quick deke or a quick fake. And here's the feed inside in the traffic. Zywicki with the fake and then finishing down low. That's a tremendous goal. Zywicki with the fake. Fakes far side, finishes near side. Tremendous goal there. Tremendous hands by number 9 from the University of Massachusetts, Jeff Zywicki.
So Zywicki now with 21 goals on the season. Came in with 19. Time of that goal at 4:34. Zywicki tonight has 2 goals and 4 assists, totaling 6 points.
He's totaled in on half of the San Jose goals here tonight. He's a tremendous offensive player. He's one of the bright young stars in this league who has a tremendous future ahead of him.
Well, New York has an extraordinary hospital for knee and shoulder injuries. It's the Center for Advanced Orthopedics at South Nassau Community's Hospital, the official hospital of the New York Titans. The physicians team at South Nassau has put more than 100 professional athletes back into action. Visit southnassau.org. Well, Jeff Zywicki has been the difference in this one. In talking to Coach Walt Christensen, he said that Zywicki is just so consistent, game in and game out. He is a natural goal scorer.
You really is, Carl. We've said it over and over, but he's got just some unbelievable hands.
Tumbling through the crease, and then the rebound score! Somehow a crazy carom, and it got past Anthony Cosmo.
I tell you, Carl, we've seen some really pretty goals here tonight. This one is a little bit on the ugly side, but it counts just as the same. We saw here Gaywa Schindler getting a free run to the goal here. San Jose lost him. Gaywa tries to shoot this one over the top, over the cage. The rebound bounces out in front, off a San Jose player, and into the net. And Carl, when you're checking out the score sheet, it still counts as a goal. Here it is.
Well, that was the eighth of the season for Gaywa Schindler. And it's a three-goal game at 12-9, San Jose leading it. Time of that goal at 4:53 of the fourth quarter. Three goals in 9.5 minutes is a little bit of a tough task, but you know what? You can score goals at a rapid rate in this league. And you play defense, get the possession back, and see what happens. Well, here's one possession upcoming. See if they can cash in. Here's 47, Jeff Spano. He had the tying goal earlier in the third quarter at 7 for the New York Titans.
And all you're talking about on the bench at this point, Carl, is doing the little things. We have to play good defense. The Titans, every time down the floor, they can't give up any more. They're going to get a few more goals. The key is, can they stop the stealth?
Well, that's a good save right there by Cosmo, but they get it right back to the Titans. Trying to duck in there and pull down from behind. We've got a whistle. There's going to be a penalty. When we come back, the New York Titans, who have been 0-4 on the power play tonight with an opportunity to cash in right after this timeout. Fans, get your tickets for New York Titans lacrosse. The Titans return to Madison Square Garden on March 3rd to take on the Toronto Rock at 8 o'clock. Individual game tickets for all Titans regular season home games at the Garden and Nassau Coliseum are available on sale now at Ticketmaster or arena box offices. Visit nytitans.com or call 1-888-8-TITANS for more info. Reserve your tickets now.
And, Carl, you know what? This one's not very pretty, but it counts the same. Here's Gaywa trying to dip and dunk over the cage. On the San Jose stealth there, Joe Vassell tries to control the rebound, and he actually ends up knocking it into the goal. And here's Ryan Boyle getting to the cage, getting dragged down, giving the Titans the opportunity right now to go on the power play, and let's see if they can cut this to within two.
Sedgwick is in the box for San Jose. Doorstep missing was McClellan. Fighting behind the cage. Chasing it down, it rolls all the way out to Brendan Mundorf. Up high, Casey Powell behind his back it goes. That was Boyle. Return for Powell. He looks down low, whipping it around to Boyle. Boyle playing catch. Here's Casey Powell up high. Far side it goes, looking to get it in tighter. McClellan can't hold on, and then Cosmo, the big stick in the goal crease, and he corrals.
I'll tell you, they really need to attack from the left-hand side of the floor. San Jose is really playing the right-handed players. The Titans need to find a way here on this power play to be able to attack from the left-hand side and finish.
1:10 to go on this power play opportunity for the New York Titans. Killing some time, Colin Doyle, number 7 for San Jose. Tries to back in, but he's double-teamed. He's going absolutely nowhere. The ball comes loose. Kevin Galbraith had a violation there, not getting that shot off in time. We'll give it right back to New York with 53 seconds left on the power play.
And very good defense on the power play there. You don't want to, you don't have to take the ball away. You just want to make sure you play solid defense. Don't give up any easy looks.
Halfway through this fourth quarter of play, Titans on the power play. Need to get one here, down by 3. There's Boyle. Again, it goes behind the cage, and that is a cat goalie, Anthony Cosmo, number 44 for San Jose. San Jose, they'll look to kill some more clock right now. Clock. Do no harm to them if they had to give the ball.
Save percentage, a terrific job by him tonight.
That penalty has expired, and now New York is one of seven. And the difference of is 4-5. To three, that's your score, Sal Acasio.
It's clear tonight to this with McCall. We still have 60 games to go. A lot of time.
Casey Powell trying to catch Cosmo off balance, fired it over his shoulder on net without looking.
Look for the Titans here to go 6-on-5 right now.
They pulled the goalie. Vince is out. So this will be a delay. And once again, the Titans on the whistle will have an opportunity. 1-7 so far tonight to see if they can catch it here first. Boyle down low. The save right on by Anthony Cosmo.
The angle there. Stay. Here's Powell behind the back as usual. Ball down to McClellan. Huge power opportunity over here. 6 minutes to go. Are dead at three, but they've got a huge opportunity. Coming around cage, boom, behind the back.
In the Titans team is going to have to cash in if they get a game that only has 43 left.
Really struggling. Got another opportunity here, and it's going into this game.
One on the that percentage is going down as this game and they let it run out. They Morrison, who put up the field with 1:10. Thrown away by Casey. Four.
They don't really. Shot.